Okay, the needle's on the record. Cue up the beat. We can start the show.
What's up, guys? DJ GhostNotes here, and today I thought we would change it up a bit and I'd do my top five in one of my favorite pizza restaurants in Melbourne. We are at S.P.Q.R Pizzeria in the heart of the city. I play here quite regularly, so I kind of know my way around the building. Every time I come in, I walk into the little DJ booth here. And I noticed down the bottom, all of these bad boys. Check it out. So I thought today we'd do something different and just kind of dig in there and see what we can find. Let's pull out five cool records. I've no idea what's in there. I've had a really quick look through, pulled a few out, and I discovered there's a lot of trash in there, but there's also a few gems, I'm hoping. So let's find out. I gotta say, guys, I'm only a couple of minutes in and I'm finding some absolute gold in here. This is a fun dig, it's really cool. Like, a lot of these records are scratched up, they're missing the records, the covers are there, there's no vinyl inside. They look like they've been, I'm not gonna say abused, but let's say, you know, they've seen better days. I got a shout out to Tom Showtime as well for letting us come down here and just dig through all of his old records. He tells me that this is all the stuff that he doesn't play anymore, and it's like, you know, mostly just stuff that he doesn't care about. All his good stuff's at home, so I think the next trip we're gonna have to do is at his place, but this is cool. I'm finding some absolute gems here. I can't wait to go through them. Okay, cool. So that was actually a lot of fun. You know, going through someone's personal record collection, it's weird. It's sort of like going through someone's underwear drawer. It feels like it's a personal thing. Tom's a producer and a DJ and an amazing man both, and just a real cool guy. And he obviously, I can tell, he's bought a lot of these records just to sample or just to see if there's any interesting sounds on the record. However, there is also a lot of pretty funky stuff in here. I'm kind of keen to go through it. Some originals, let's have a look. So J Live, Miles Away. This is Space Jazz, Funky Drops, and I see this record around. Best of De La Soul, Lee Perry and the Upsetters. You know, nothing that's really like super rare, but like I said, this is his throw it in the restaurant selection. And Fiddler, some cool tracks on this. Used to play I Believe in You a lot, really bassy, funky track. You'll have to forgive me, guys, I've got hay fever at the moment, so I sound a bit congested and gross, I apologise about that. Bay Area Funk, that's an interesting one. This one looks interesting. Soft Tones, Black Magic, I don't know who these guys are. Ah, just a classic album, look at that. Some of these originals start to fetch a fair bit of money now. Not in this condition when they're all falling apart, but this is one of my all-time favorite albums. It's just a dope album. Like, actually grabbed one of Lauryn Hill's albums from here as well. Let me see if I can find it. Here we go, right there. Absolutely amazing album. Every single track on this album is killer. How many tracks came off this album? So well produced, such a talented woman, Lauryn Hill. Into hip hop, Cypress Hill. I love some of these records, the Bossa Nova records. Just, what a cover though, check that out. On the back, kind of keen to hear this one. Sort of depends on the songs that they choose to cover, doesn't it? You know, another classic. It's got a couple of these as well. These are just the dopest records for DJs because, you know, one record has like 12 classic funk and jazz breaks. That soul, Pink Floyd. Ever heard of Fleetwood Mac? Ever heard of Pink Floyd? Ever heard of a little band called the Beatles? Ever heard of Massive Attack? Had a few records. No comment. John Coltrane. Charlie Parker. Legend. Tribe. This is actually the Hits and Rarities Remixes album. So, you know, I'm doing some dope stuff on there. And James Brown's Greatest Breakbeats. That's got to be good. So let's have a listen.
And he was six. We rode on horses made of sticks. He wore black and I wore white. He would always win the fight. Bang, bang, he shot me down. Bang, bang, I hit the ground. Bang, bang, that awful sound. Bang, bang, my baby shot me down.
Sniffing cocaine, holding an M16. See, with the pen, I'm extreme now. Y'all know my steelo, with or without the airplay. I keep some E and J sitting bent up in a spinner. spinner.
That was actually a lot of fun. It's really interesting going through somebody's record collection because you kind of get an understanding of the person themselves and what they're into and what their influences are and what they gravitate towards in terms of music. So it was really fun. Thanks again to the guys down at SPQR Pizzeria in the city on Liverpool Street. If you haven't been to SPQR and you're in Melbourne, check it out. It's dope. The food is amazing. Wood-fired pizzas and gnocchi and the garlic bread. It's all on point. Obviously, like always, good music when you go in from, I think, Tuesday nights, Thursdays, Fridays, Saturday. That's just cool. Yeah, I managed to find five dope tunes out of the plethora of stuff that I could choose from. I actually ran out of time while I was down there. I spent so much time filming that I sort of ran out of time to handpick songs and find really unique stuff. But I think the five records that I've chosen are all significant and individually really interesting anyway. We started off with James Brown, Funky Breaks, and I mean, that was just easy. There's just so much cool stuff on there that was always going to be a winner. Bang Bang by Nancy Sinatra. Obviously, that's been covered a bunch of times. I didn't know that Cher was the original performer of that song. Sunny wrote the track, she performed it. And there's actually a really cool version of that by a lady called Betty Chung. I believe she's Singaporean, maybe singing in Chinese, but that's a really dope seven. Very expensive, hard to come by, but it's worth checking out. Nas Illmatic, dope album. I mean, that whole album's nuts. Premiere worked on it, Q-Tip. Large Professor still holds up today as one of the best hip-hop albums to come out. So thanks again to all the people that are watching and supporting. If you have any questions at all, please send me a message, let me know. Otherwise, until next week, peace.
One day, I'm gonna understand. Unsure what the balance held, I touched my belly.